Yes, Swamini. Yes.
Sir, which chapter you are reading?
It's first chapter. Aman, please mute yourself. It's first chapter matter. We are discussing cooperation today. Page number 19. Page number 19. Page number 9. Aman, mute yourself. Page number 19 we are discussing.
Evaporation.
Evaporation we will be discussing. Okay. Okay, so listen here. If you want to say something or ask something, you can raise your hand. Okay, when you have to ask something, raise your hand. I will unmute you. Okay, so we are starting with evaporation today. So till now we have discussed boiling, that is at 100 boiling we have discussed, that is any liquid we take and its boiling point is this, the temperature is reached and it starts to convert into its gaseous state. So this conversion takes place at particular temperature. That temperature is called as boiling point. But evaporation, in evaporation as well, liquid get converted into its gaseous state. Liquid get converted to its gaseous state. But at any temperature, below its boiling point. Yes, Arjun. You can unmute and ask. Anita. Okay, so liquid, it can convert into gaseous state at any temperature, that is at any temperature below boiling point. Because at boiling point, it will get converted to gaseous state by boiling. So below boiling point, at any temperature, the liquid get converted into its gaseous state. So for example, we have wet clothes. You have seen that after washing the clothes, we used to dry them outside. So outside what happens? It contains water. Wet clothes contain water. So these water will keep on evaporating. That is, it will keep on losing the surface of the clothes. It will keep on losing the surface of the clothes and getting converted into vapor state. Okay. Or for example, you have seen, like on the floor, you have dropped some water. And as time passes, you will see the amount of water keeps on decreasing. Amount of water on the floor, it keeps on decreasing. So what is happening? That is, water is getting converted into its gaseous state. At any temperature, this water is getting converted into its gaseous state. Okay. So water gets converted and it keeps on becoming smaller and smaller. You have seen it? All the clothes get dried. All the wet towel we have that used to get dry. That those all things happen because of evaporation. So more examples we'll be discussing later. So for example, we have to demonstrate evaporation phenomena. Okay. So how we can demonstrate evaporation? Floor on floor we'll pour some water. Some water we have sprinkled on the floor. Okay, it will become wet. Now see here, we keep on observing the floor. The floor will keep on getting dry. That is, water is being lost, that is liquid water. Water is getting converted into its vapor state or gaseous state. And at what temperature it is taking place? At any temperature it can take place. At any temperature it can take place. Okay, this is here. So what are the important factors for evaporation? That is, first, it takes place at all temperature below its boiling point. Evaporation takes place at all temperatures. It takes place at all temperatures below its boiling point. Okay, this is the first factor you must remember. That is, what are the important factors for evaporation? It takes place at all temperatures below its boiling point. At all temperatures, evaporation takes place. Second point, where does evaporation take place? It takes place on the surface. For example, this is a container, this is a water frame. So on the surface, evaporation will take place. Why does it take place on the surface only? That we are going to discuss after some time. When we discuss the... Yes, Soumya, you can ask.
One question is there, a liquid does not evaporate below its boiling point. Sir, it is true or false?
It's false. Okay, we will discuss that as well. That point is it takes place below its boiling point. At any temperature it takes place, we will be discussing many examples. It will become many more clear when we discuss the examples. Okay? When we discuss the examples, it will become more clear. Okay? So, first point regarding evaporation, it takes place at all temperatures. So, for example, water. Its boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius. So, evaporation can take place at 5 degrees Celsius, it takes place at 10 degrees Celsius, 15, 30, 40, 50, 60, 80, 89, 90. At all temperature below its boiling point, evaporation takes place. Okay? We can take one example as well. For example, you have a washed your clothes. That is, you have washed the towel and you have dried it inside a room, okay? But still you will see that it used to get dry after some time. It used to get dry after some time. You haven't heated the towel, but still it's getting dry. Why? Is it boiling or just evaporation? It is because of evaporation. Temperature haven't reached 100 degrees Celsius. Temperature of the towel haven't reached 100 degrees Celsius. We haven't started a burner below it, but still it got dry. That means liquid water containing the towel get vaporized, get converted into its gaseous state. So we can say evaporation takes place at all temperature below its boiling point. At any temperature it can take place below its boiling point. This is here. Second, it takes place on the surface. It takes place on the surface. For example, you have, okay, take one example here. For example, you washed the two towels you have washed. One towel you just crumpled and left. Other towel you have spread it out and dried. So which towel will get dried first? The towel which you have spread or dried it properly. Other towel which have been crumpled, it will dry. It will take much time. Why? Because the towel which you have spread, it has more surface area, so more evaporation. And this towel crumpled one, it has less surface area, less evaporation. Understood this one? So, evaporation takes place on surface. It takes place on surface, that is free surface of the liquid. Free surface of liquid. This is our second important factor, point regarding evaporation. It takes place on the free surface of the liquid. More the free surface, more evaporation. More the free surface, more evaporation. Okay? Last one, it is a slow process, slow and silent. You don't hear any sound. Slow and silent process. You as well have seen when water boils, it starts to make sound. But when water evaporates, it doesn't make any sound. It is very silent process. Very slow as well. When you have dried the towel, it will take time to get dried. It will take time to dry. So these are the three important points regarding evaporation. First one, at all temperature take place below boiling point. Second one, evaporation take place on free surface of the liquid. More the free surface, more evaporation. It is slow and silent process. It is very slow and silent. It doesn't make any sound. It silently does its work. It silently does its work. Okay. This is clear. Now we discuss factors affecting evaporation. What are the factors that affects evaporation? Mainly we will be discussing factors affecting rate of evaporation, that is whether the evaporation will be fast or it will be slow. Okay, that we will be discussing. Factors affecting the rate of evaporation, which are the factors? Affecting rate of evaporation. So the first factor, nature of the liquid. First is nature of the liquid. What kind of liquid we have taken? Okay. So here take one example. For example, you took two towels, one cloth you have washed with glycerin. You have dipped in glycerin, other cloth you have dipped in water. Now dry them. Which will dry faster? The towel, right? Which was dipped in water will dry faster. Okay. So different liquids go different rate of evaporation. It depends on the nature of evaporation. For example, you take spirit, alcohol. Okay. For example, you take spirit and water. Which will get evaporated faster, spirit or water? Spirit will get evaporated faster? Yes or no? Or take petrol. Petrol, you all know? Petrol and water. Which will get evaporated faster? Petrol. Petrol will get evaporated faster. This is clear?
Yes,
or
sir.
Take example. Yes. If you are doubt, raise your hand, okay? I'll unmute you. If you are doubt, raise your hand, I'll unmute you. Okay. Or take example of water and glycerin. Which evaporates faster? Water or glycerin? Which evaporate faster? Water will evaporate faster. Water will evaporate faster. Okay. So if you have any doubt, just raise your hand. Particular student, I will unmute. Okay. If you have doubt, just raise your hand, I'll unmute you. Okay, so first is nature of the liquid. So rate of evaporation depends on nature of liquid. What kind of liquid we have taken, depending on that, evaporation will take. Rate of evaporation will be affected. Second is temperature. Second is temperature. Okay, so for example, in summer, in my you know, next month it will be very dry and high temperature. So you wash one cloth in my and dry and note down the time, how much time it takes to dry. Okay, now the same cloth you have washed in winter, in December, on 31st December you washed one cloth, same towel and dry, and note the time how much it takes to dry. So you will see that in hot summer, when the weather is hot. Hot weather, in hot weather, and we have your cold weather. We have here hot weather, and here we have cold weather. Okay. So in hot weather, the temperature will be high. Temperature will be high. And here temperature will be low. So if temperature is high, our clothes get dried faster. Our clothes get dried faster. When temperature is low, the clothes will take time to dry. That is, when in hot weather, when temperature is high, the liquid evaporates faster. The liquid evaporates faster. When temperature is low, liquid takes time to evaporate. This is clear. The concept behind this we'll be discussing when we discuss the molecular theory of matter. Based on molecular theory, based on kinetic theory, we'll be explaining evaporation again. Okay. So I'm giving you a brief idea about them. We'll be discussing them again when we discuss the kinetic theory. Okay. So when temperature is high, evaporation will be faster. When temperature is low, evaporation will be slow. It will be slow. So our clothes take time to dry in winter. In winter, the clothes take time to dry, whereas in summer, they dry very fast. They dry very fast. Because in summer, temperature is high, in winter, temperature is slow. This is clear. Or you can take example, two clothes, same kind of two towels you took, one you have dried in shade, other you have dried in sun. So in sun, it will be temperature high, whereas in shade, temperature will be low. So the towel which we have dried in sun, it will get dried faster. That is, evaporation will be faster in sun as compared to the evaporation in shade. This is clear. Next is surface area. Third is surface area. Okay. We will discuss the concept behind these all once again. Surface area. More the free surface, more the free surface, more the evaporation. More the free surface, more the evaporation. Less the free surface, less the evaporation. Okay. So that's why we used to spread out the clothes while drying. We used to spread out the clothes. So that surface area increases. Free surface area increases and clothes get dried easily. Or clothes get dried faster. This is clear. So evaporation depends on nature of liquid, temperature, surface area. Next is, it depends on flow of air. It depends on flow of air. Okay, this example you can take, for example, in a room. We have dried one towel and we noted the time. Okay, and next time we dried the same cloth, but this time we started the fan. So, what fan will do? It will blow the air, flow of air will be there. So, see what is happening. For example, this is our towel, it has water, it is wet towel, water it has. Now, when it is, what is evaporating? What will happen? Near the towel. The water molecules evaporate and they will be in the gaseous state. They will be in the gaseous state here. Now see here. But when the air is flowing, what will happen? Air will sweep them away. Will sweep them away. Okay? It will move them away. Now more space is created. More molecules of water will get evaporated, converted into gaseous. Again by air, they will sweep away. They will be moved away. Okay? So, if air is flowing, evaporation will be faster. If air is flowing, evaporation will be faster. You can take example as in daily life. When wind is flowing, your clothes get dried faster. Because whatever water has evaporated, converted into liquid, it lies near the surface of the liquid, lies near the surface of the towel, and layer makes them move away. Now more space is created, and again evaporation takes place. So, flow of air makes them heat faster. Next is humidity of air. Humidity of air. This, for example, you have seen in, for example, you dry the clothes now, it will dry faster. But in June, when the rain starts to take place, around 20th June or 30th, rainfall starts to take place in Rajasthan, and you see air will be humid. Our clothes will take time to dry. Why? See here, humid air, it already contains water molecules. It already contains water molecules. So, the evaporation will be slow. Why? The molecules which are escaping from the liquid, they will have less room because air is already containing more moisture, more humid. So these molecules, they will have less room to be there. So evaporation slows down. If humidity is more, evaporation will be slow. This is clear. Okay, this. Okay, based on kinetic theory of matter. Now we discuss the kinetic theory. Based on that, I'll be explaining them all again. Okay. Now we'll see why they are taking place. Okay. Based on kinetic theory of, we'll be studying. So we have taken the liquid. This is our liquid. Okay. Take some molecules. Molecules are there. Okay. Many are there. I'm taking only these much molecules of water. Okay. Now what they are doing? They are rotating, they are vibrating. These molecules are rotating, They are vibrating as well. They are moving here and there as well. So what is happening? These molecules, they collide with each other. These molecules are colliding with each other. They are colliding with the surface of the container as well. They collide and bounce back. So when collisions are taking place between molecules, what is happening? There is a transfer of energy from one molecule to the other. There is transfer of energy from one molecule to the other. So here, take example of two molecules. This is one. Okay. I'm taking example of two molecules. Okay. For example, this is water. This is the surface. Okay. This is our surface. Okay. Take one molecule here, one molecule here. Okay. These molecules are moving in any direction. For example, this molecule collides with this molecule. They collide with each other. There will be transfer of energy, for example, from this molecule. Energy is transferred to this molecule. When they collide, energy got transferred from second molecule to the first molecule. Okay? So first molecule is having more energy. Second molecule is having less energy. Less energy means its temperature will decrease. Whereas first molecule, its temperature will increase. Understood? Because more the energy, more the kinetic energy, more the temperature. So now see what will happen. These two molecules collide, and from second molecule, energy transfer to the first molecule. So first molecule has more energy. It is more energy, so it will move more faster. Okay? It will move more faster. Again, it collides with the third one. Again, it took energy from the third one. It again moves more faster, and now see what happens. After a few molecules, one molecule have get very much energy, and these molecules comes near the surface. Okay, now see, since it has gained more energy, it will overcome all the bonds. It will overcome all the bonds, and it will leave the surface. It will leave the surface. When it left the surface, you will say that it has converted into some water, converted into vapor state. Some water converted into gaseous state. Now, again, the other molecules, they are colliding again and again each other. So some of the molecules, they will gain sufficient energy to leave the surface, to break away the bonds and leave the surface. This is how these molecules will keep on leaving the surface. They keep on leaving the surface and colliding here and there. Okay. So what is happening? As they are leaving the surface, the level of water, it will decrease. Level of the liquid will decrease. And something more is happening there. What is happening? See here, when these molecules, they have taken the energy, the other molecules will have less energy, and these molecules have less. So these are molecules which have left, they have more energy, more the temperature they will be, and those molecules which have given the energy, lost the energy, they will have less kinetic energy, less temperature. This is how our liquid will get cooled. Our liquid is getting cooled because the molecules which are remaining inside the liquid, they are having less energy. Less the energy, less the temperature. This is how our liquid is getting cooled. So as molecules are taking the energy from the liquid or from the surrounding, from the air as well they take, from the container as well they take, and from the other molecules of water as well they take, and they keeps on living. Okay, there is player unknown. Okay, player unknown, please put your name correctly, then come to the class. This is how they live. Okay, I'm unmuting this player unknown, and let's see. Yes, you can unmute yourself and can ask the doubt. Okay, so we are moving further. This is clear. Everyone have understood? Anyone have doubt? Raise your hand. Anyone in class having doubt? Raise your hand. You have understood this one? So may you can unmute yourself and can ask. Arpita, I will unmute you.
Sir, yes. I have lost.
Yes.
Sir, I cannot understand.
Sir, that is. Sir, I ask you a question that I have asked you a question before that the boiling the water can evaporate in any state or not?
No, at any temperature you are asking.
Yes, sir.
At any temperature water can evaporate. At any temperature water can evaporate below its boiling point, because at 100 degrees Celsius water will boil. But at the boiling point, the liquid will boil. So there is no case of asking evaporation.
Sir, so
evaporation can take place at any temperature below its boiling point. So water, it can evaporate at 30 degrees Celsius, 40, 35, 37.5, any temperature it can ask. It can take place. Yes, Arpit, any more? Yes.
Sir, in chemistry, sir, that ma'am told that a liquid does not evaporate below its boiling point is true.
Okay, maybe by mistake she may have thought. Okay, discuss with your chemistry teacher. But water can evaporate at any temperature below its boiling point. It mainly evaporation takes place below its boiling point. At boiling point, it will start to boil. So okay, you can ask your chemistry teacher. By mistake, it may happen. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, Arpit, you can ask.
Sir, I not understand last one.
Last one, which one? Humidity.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll discuss that one. Ujjwal, you can ask. Ujjwal. Okay, just give me 1 minute. Okay. Someone from your class is doing all these nonsense activities. See here, it is not going to help you in any way. Okay? It's not going to help that person in any way. Use your energy for something productive work. Rather disturbing here, use that energy in some productive work that may help you, that may lead you to proceed further in your life. Okay? So, last point, humidity we'll discuss. We'll move from one by one again. Okay? So, this you understood? What is happening in evaporation? Free surface is there. Molecules, they keep on colliding. Okay? They keep on colliding with the container wall, they collide with other molecules of the substance. That is, for example, water we have taken, they collide with water as well. They collide with other water molecules. And there is a transfer of energy among them. So, these molecules of water, they can take energy from the container wall, they can take energy from the other molecules of water, they can take energy from the free surface, that is from the atmosphere, from the surrounding as well, they can take energy. Okay. Now, when they have got the sufficient energy, they have more kinetic energy. This energy is nothing but kinetic energy. Now, they will break away the mold. When they reach the free surface, they will leave, they have sufficient energy to leave the surface. They left. But other molecules whose energy have reduced, temperature reduces, and the liquid is getting cooled. Liquid is getting cooled now. Okay. Yes, Soumya, you can ask.
Time over.
Okay, you understood? Okay. Now, next one. This is clear. Now, nature of the liquid. Different liquids have different intermolecular space, different intermolecular force. Okay? Depending on them, different amount of kinetic energy is required to leave the surface. So, nature of the liquid, first one. So, those liquids which have weaker intermolecular force, they can easily evaporate. At very less temperature, they will evaporate. So depending on the nature of the liquid, day-to-day operation takes place or is affected. Okay, next one, temperature. Next one is temperature. Okay, so see here, if one liquid we have taken at 40 degrees Celsius, other liquid is at 50 degrees Celsius. Okay, so which liquid has having 11, 10, time is over. Okay, temperature, see here. So this liquid, these molecules are already have more energy as compared to like this liquid having temperature 40 degrees. The liquid which is at 40 degrees Celsius, this is more kinetic energy. More kinetic energy means more evaporation will take place. Less temperature, less kinetic energy, less evaporation will take place. So more higher the temperature, more the evaporation. So you have seen water captain, one is shed in captain shed, other is we have captain sun. So water which has been kept in sun, it will evaporate more faster because temperature will gain energy from the sun. More higher the temperature will be there. More higher the temperature of the water in the sun will be there. So it get evaporate faster. Whereas the water which has been shed, its temperature is low. It will take time to evaporate. Okay, rest we discuss tomorrow. Okay. Okay, rest we discuss tomorrow. Whenever we have the next period. Okay. Okay. Thank you all.